Hello friends, welcome back to All About Structural Analysis and Design. So in our previous video, we have seen the analysis of singly reinforced beam, and in those calculations we have came across the words effective depth and effective cover. And I have received a lot of comments that what is the difference between effective cover and clear cover. Okay, so in this video we shall see what is the difference between those both covers. Okay, and before moving on to this video, we shall see what is meant by cover or why we provide cover for an RCC element. Okay, so in your day-to-day life, you have never seen the reinforcing bar in a structural element. Okay, it will be always covered with concrete. So why we cover everything with concrete and why steel is not visible? Okay, so if it is visible, what happens? The steel will come in contact with your air, water or salts, and there is a 100% chance that steel may corrode with this external agents. So we are not supposed to keep our reinforcing bars outside or in a, or it should not be exposed to the environment, because if it corrodes, then the problem of RCC element starts. So the protection, whatever we have to provide, it is known as the concrete cover. Okay, so that is the main thing why we provide cover, because we have to protect our steel from the corrosion. And in analysis and design problems, you have came across these words, effective cover or clear cover, they say sometimes. So what is the difference between those covers? I will explain. Okay, so these are the two sections I have taken. Okay, having an overall depth D, having width B. Now there are three small D's. One is here small D, one is D dash, and one is D double dash. Okay, so whatever you are seeing here D, small D, it is known as effective depth. And whatever you have seen D dash here, it is known as effective cover. And this D double dash is clear cover. So what is the difference between D dash and D double dash? Effective cover, that is D dash, is nothing but the distance measured from the face of the member. Okay, so this is your face of the member, it is covered with concrete. Your cover is this. Okay, so this is concrete cover, concrete, and whatever you are seeing, this one is stirrups. Okay, the stirrups are nothing but made from steel. Okay, so effective cover is the distance measured from the face of the member, this is the face of the member, to the center of reinforcement. So whatever dotted lines I have shown with the red color, it is the center of reinforcement. And the effective cover is measured from the face of the member to the center of reinforcement. Whereas here D double dash, if you see, the definition goes like this. Clear cover is the distance measured from the exposed concrete surface. So this is the exposed concrete surface. And one more important thing is without plastering or any other finishes. Plastering is not counted as cover. Okay, remember this thing. So exposed concrete surface to the nearest surface of reinforcement. So the nearest surface of reinforcement is this stirrup. Okay, not even this main bar. So the nearest surface is stirrups. So the distance between from the exposed concrete surface to the nearest surface of the reinforcement is known as clear cover. And for calculations or in analysis, or it may be designs, we always take effective cover. Okay, so I'll mention here what is here D. D is your overall depth. Small d is your effective depth. And D dash, effective cover. D double dash, clear cover. And P is width of beam. Okay, so I think now it is clear. I will write definition of effective cover here. Effective cover is defined as the distance measured from the face of the member to the center of reinforcement. And the definition of clear cover goes like this. Distance measured from the face of the member okay, without plaster. This is main thing, okay, without plaster to the nearest surface of reinforcement, So this is the basic difference between D dash and D double dash. I hope now the difference between effective cover and clear cover has been cleared. And if you have understood this video, please like this video, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe All About Structural Analysis and Design, and also press the bell icon for the latest notifications of videos in civil and structural engineering. Thank you, friends.